Today's presentation, Hamilton in China, a hip-hop tour of present-day China's biggest political, geopolitical, and macroeconomic issues. A parody rapper by hobby, Andrew Dougherty is the China economist and Asia research director for Capital Strategy Research. He joined the Capital Group in 2004 as a participant in the Associates Program, which is their two-year investment management rotational program, and founded and has been based in Capital's Beijing office since 2009. He received a BA in Economics and International Affairs from the George Washington University and an MPhil in Modern Chinese Studies from Cambridge University. He speaks Mandarin Chinese and Russian. Please give it up for Andrew Dougherty.
So it's great to be with you all today. One or two interesting biographical notes. Probably the most important thing that should be in my introduction or biography is that I spent one spring term at BYU. In the spring of 2004, I had just gone to China for part of my master's degree, and then SARS hit, and they sort of canceled all the programs, and they offered us to either stay in China or go back to Cambridge, which is where I was at, and I thought, you know, I'd never been to the land of milk and honey, so I came and did some Chinese classes here and classes at the Marriott School. Had a great experience. So it's great to come back to BYU. Also, my middle name happens to be Hamilton. This was sort of the double entendre for the title for today. I wanted to just start by canvassing this group a little bit and getting a feel for your backgrounds and your interests. To see if you're here really for China or for hip-hop or to heckle me. As I have a couple old mission buddies in the back. How many folks here have studied China in a classroom environment to some degree? Okay, pretty good percentage. How many can name the current leader of China? Okay, all right. And how many people have been to China? Oh, wow, okay, not too bad. Great, so we have a great sort of baseline to go off of. I'll be using in some of my presentation material today some acronyms and references that may not necessarily be familiar. Hopefully you'll get the feel or the vibe of what I'm trying to communicate, and I'm happy to answer questions as we get to Q&A towards the end and clear up any maybe confusions that have come up over the course of our discussion. The next point I wanted to make is sort of three points. First of all, this is going to be basically a concert format. This is not really a pure lecture. It's a rap lecture. I like to call it a rapture. And raptures are, by definition, not a passive experience. Most of you have probably been to a concert. I'm going to expect you guys to work hard with me so that this is an interactive and productive and engaging experience. And so I might sort of encourage you, and I look forward to seeing your participation. We'll practice a little bit before we get started. Secondly, the arc of the lecture will kind of start with politics, domestic politics in China. We'll move from that after discussing that and aspects of the Chinese political situation to the economics, and from there a bit to the social issues in China. In between the songs, I've written kind of lyrical interludes, and so we're going to go kind of straight through. So we'll save all questions to the end. If you have questions come up, you know, put them on your phone or write them down. Would love to take them at the end. And finally, this is the first time I've ever done this in this format. I've sort of done a rap here or a rap there and then given a normal lecture. I've never done the entire lecture. I've never done a rapture. So this is sort of experimental. And not only do I need your help to keep the energy up, but I've never done it at high altitudes in dry climate. So I don't know how my voice is going to hold up over six or seven songs. So you'll have to bear with me. Hopefully this goes better than one might expect for the first time. And so let's practice. Let's get into this a little bit, okay? So there's probably two or three things I might ask you to do over the course of the rapture. And the first is put your hands together. Okay. But let's do it together, right? So like, all right, you guys are pretty, that's a good start. All right, the second thing, I'm not gonna make you do it now, is get out your seats and shake it a little bit, okay? Now, I'm not going to make you do this a lot, but there might come a time where the vibe is there and the energy's there and y'all start feeling it, and I just give you one of these, and everybody gets up, and we start doing our thing, okay? The last one is, I've lectured in Beijing to some BYU groups that have come through, and as I've done some of these raps, sometimes they start singing along, so don't be shy. If you know the tune and you see the lyrics, then please, by all means, join in, because I'm actually not a very good singer, but I've got some background tunes. Okay, without further ado, let's get this going. With the advent of a new leadership in 2012, China changed dramatically, misperceptions dispelled. There was only one political narrative at the time, the factional framework of Jiang Zemin versus, wait, I got a rhyme, Hu Jintao with his Chuan Pai on the other side. It was clear that corruption would be a policy priority, but no one predicted the pace, scope, or depth of the campaign in this unpredictable place. It's a good reminder of the first point I'm making today. Politics is paramount in China. Let me hear y'all say, politics is paramount in China. Let me hear y'all say, politics is paramount in China. Let me hear y'all say, politics is paramount in China. Let me hear y'all say. Let me hear y'all say. Yeah. All right, here we go. If we can get it to come up. We need some volume, Michael. Can we get some background volume? Yeah.
Just hope your last name isn't Bored.
Cheer.
Only thing that some man who's gonna run this town tonight.
Cheer.
Come on,
y'all.
Who's gonna run this town tonight?
I'm coming at y'all. Cheer. We are, yeah, I said that we are. This is Jiang Nation. Pledge your allegiance. The three represent, son. Princeling is everything. Heritage, parentage, your princeling is everything. Xi Jinping's my number one. Wang Jishan's another one. I got Yu Zhengsheng. Yeah, my boys, I'm really feeling them. It's about familia. I'll explain later. But for now, let me get back to this paper. Jiang and Jiang Gao Li are only loyal to me. Liu Yunshan's my boy, although he's from the Youth League. Yeah, I'm talking five members, six members. Now we controlling the whole standing committee in the city. Now we rolling. Who won?
Life's a game, but it's not fair.
Cheer.
Break the rules, so I don't care.
Cheer.
Cause I'm connected to the man.
That's
so
right.
That's why I'm so cavalier.
Cheer.
Jiang Zemin is on my side.
Cheer.
Disagree, I'll override. Only thing that's on my mind. Who gon' run this town tonight?
Cheer. We are Li Keqiang and me are, y'all can call me Jin Tao, Wang Yang and Yuan Chao, please follow the leader, Chuan Pai's who we are, we lost a bit of ground on this political seesaw, yo Banfa, ma, but we're the ones who savvy, we're in local, governments everywhere, and so they say forget the other side, they jealous, maybe they're Shang Yo Junction, but Xia Yo Dweitzer fellas. Cheer. And one day Jiang won't make his birthday, so they should throw their hand in, cause then they go to Ace of Spades.
Cheer.
My whole team got dough. Wen Jiabao's ass, it's a mode in Xi Jinping's, yo. Cheer.
Life's a game, but it's not fair. I break the rules, so I don't care.
Cheer.
Cause I'm connected to the man.
That's right.
That's why I'm so cavalier. Hu Jintao is on my side.
Cheer.
Cheer. I'll override.
Lee. My, who? Come on, cheer! Cheer! Come on, put your hands together! It's crazy how we can go from being guru of the financial sector, all Bravo Zulu. Now, Inspector General, I'm gonna pursue you. If you're corrupt, you can bet I'll prosecute you. Police escorts, all officials ask for them. But that's a past life, the future brings a vast storm. We see mass drive, we are on a crash course. What you think they asked me for? I'm J. Edgar Hoover. But corruption ain't the only thing we tackle in harmonious society. We building social housing as the rich got richer, the poor we been shackling. We gotta close the wealth gap between Beijing and Baoding. Land rights and hukou still need reforming. Migrant workers wonder, why do all ignore me? And that's a warning, like that morning when Chun Guang Chun just slipped right out the precinct. We don't care about the drama that the foreigners bring. We assertive now, we won't be appeasing. Diao Yu, baby, we South China seizing. You heard about our carrier, we calling it the Liaoning. And how this all plays in the newsreels is decided, what? By how she feels. You tripping if you're thinking that we'd freewheel. You thought we liberalized, not this monopoly deal. Yeah. Cheer. Hey, 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 hey. Cheer. We're gonna run this town tonight.
Thank you very much.
So who were the leaders of this new administration? Would Xi Jinping and Li Keqiang get policy inspiration? Xi Jinping is number one, controls the party and the gun. Even though he is the son of a reformer, Xi Jinping early on seems to showcase conservative leanings. China dream is his dream, but what kind of dream does that seem? We don't know, but it certainly has an American ring. Li Keqiang is the premier, economics are his sphere. Li's early focus was economic reform. Free trade zones and liberalization were to be the new norm. But slower growth said to reform, you'll have to wait for later. Just like Anakin said to Luke, I am your father, Darth Vader.
Michael, could we get the background track a little louder? Audio track. Y'all know this one. Snoop and Dre, baby. This old school. Y'all probably weren't born back then.
Da, 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 da.
Come on!
It's the one and only Premier League.
Good job!
Da, 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 da. You know I'm rocking with the Xi Jinping.
Cheer, cheer, cheer! You know the Gong Chang Dong is back for all you suckers! Wave your hands, wave your hands. Put them in the air like you just don't. Top down this fall. Yeah, I'm turning it up. BBOC, I hope they burning it up. CCP, CSC, yeah, we hook them back up. Zhou Xiaochuan is the bomb, but he got to step up. All my homies, no more cronies, hope they giving it up. Oh, your cheese pretty, please, you been living it up. Taking chances, that's my stance, cause we don't got that much time. Our economy got reason, but it ain't got no rhyme. Comrades looking at me strange, but you know I don't care. The one child policy and the hukou ain't fair. Y'all quit talking, start walking, got to get a move on. Interest groups get out the way, financial sector reform. Fiscal and pension reform, we got a rendezvous. And that's so easy, you best believe that I'll be coming for you. I'm in a hurry, don't you worry, hit you indirectly with Shanghai FTZ and then some TPP. Yeah, baby. Yeah, yeah. Alright, verse 2, Xi Jinping coming at you.
Da, 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 da.
It's the one and only Xi Jinping. Cheer, cheer.
Da, 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 da.
You know I'm rocking with Premier League. Straight out them killer fields of Shaanxi. Frugality leads to legitimacy. Doc Xi rolling out the Chinese dream. What you think? Shout out Muscatine. Wang Qishan busting heads here to crack. With Xi in the back taking up slack. Clipping all of Joe's boys from the hood. CNPC Sichuan understood. Seven forbiddens make up Doc Nine. Rule a lopsha, rule a lot nah. Y'all be pitching asinine. Rumor monger, stop building Castle Sweetenstein. Cause our senses on. Then your tweets are gone. You get your C on and join the reform. Cause our policies will last for eons. Xi and Li be the posse for show. Come on, real we the next episode.
Hold up.
Hey,
For my critics who be thinking we saw, we won't play. So don't compare us to no Gorbachev. Hold up. Hey, for those critics who be acting too bold, take a seat. Hope you're ready for the next episode. Hey, yeah, yeah, yeah. Reform every day.
So, excuse me, it's dry here in Utah. Xi Jinping came out the gates, all his guns a-blazing. His anti-corruption campaign's been nothing short of amazing. Wang Qishan's his deputy, does all the dirty work. He puts his shoulder to the wheel, and he don't let no one shirk. They went after big dogs, tigers, Bo Xilai and Mr. Joe. They hit military generals, Guo Boxiong and Xu Taiho. But they didn't stop at the top. They went after little flies. They had their eyes single to the glory of keeping the CCP alive. But it's only half ideology. Yeah, it's half Machiavelli. Now they don't drink Baijiu anymore. They drink Martinelli. Y'all thinking, la-di-da-di, they cleaned up the potty. But how many officials get work done? Trust me, ain't nobody. It has broken the bureaucracy. No one wants to get in trouble. But that means growth is slowing, so the problems are gonna double. But let's stop talking and start singing about political junk. Now y'all gonna put your hands together for some Jinping funk. Oh, we don't got a video for this one. So I'm gonna expect a little bit of...
Go.
Yeah, put your hands together, come on. Yeah, y'all know how this one goes. If you sing bass, then y'all start singing.
Go. Do 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 do.
Jinping, he's ice cold. Wang Qishan is so bold. This one's for Lao Baixing, who've been fighting for equality. Migrants urbanizing, moving on into the city. It's a grand yuan that we're targeting. We need the CCP to look pretty. I'm too hot. Just a minute, don't be a liar, man. I'm too hot. Make officials want to retire, man. I'm too hot. Say my name, you know who I am. I'm too hot. We gonna take back your money. Break it down. Boy hits you, hallelujah. Joe hits you, hallelujah. Boy hits you, hallelujah. Cause Jinping Fong gon' give it to you. Cause Jinping Fong gon' give it to you. Cause Jinping Fong gon' give it to you. 2015 and it's getting hot. I said don't believe me, just watch. Come on.
Get up out your seats now, come on. Everybody shake it. Yeah, come on.
Don't believe me, just watch.
Give it to me now. What y'all going? Come on, shake it in your seats then. Shake it in your seat, come on. Yeah, I said, don't believe me, just watch.
Don't believe me, just
sing with me now.
Don't believe me, just watch. Don't believe me, just watch. Hey, 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 oh, stop. Wait a minute. Fubai funds, or we eliminate them? NPC, it's a test. Qishan, get the stretch. Lai Dao Beijing, Yao Xiaoxin, cause we probably gonna nab you. Liang Hui Ho, Shuang Gui Yo. You're dumber than a hot piece of Wagyu. I'm too hot. Just admit it, don't be a liar, man. I'm too hot. Make officials wanna retire, man. I'm too hot. Joe, say my name, you know who I am. I'm too hot. We gon' take back your money. Break it down. Boy, hit you, hallelujah. War hit you, hallelujah. War hit you, hallelujah.
Come on.
Cause Jinping Funk gon' give it to you. Cause Jinping Funk gon' give it to you.
Cause
Jinping Funk gon' give it to you. CCP's gotta stop the riot. I said, don't believe me, just rock.
Come on now. You feeling it? You feeling it, baby? Get out the seat. Come on. Yeah, there we go. Rah. That's right.
I said, don't believe me, just rock.
Sing along with me. Come on. Come on. Let's get funky now. Let's get funky now. I said,
don't believe me, just watch. Don't believe me, just watch. Don't believe me, just watch.
Don't believe me, just watch. Cheers.
Hey. Before we leave, let me tell you a little something. Jinping, funk you up. Qishan, funk you up. I said, Jinping, funk you up. Qishan, funk you up. I said, Jinping, funk you up. Fine food by funk you up. Qishan, funk you up. Fine food by funk you up.
Come on, son, jump on it. If you whip mad and flown it, wanna cool mad and own it. Don't brag about it, come show me. Come on, John, jump on it. If you wet, mad, and flown it.
But it's 2015 and we stopped the riot. I said, don't believe me, just watch.
One more time. Come on, get up out your seat. Last time, ladies and gentlemen. Get out your seats. Rah! I said, don't believe me, just watch. Come on, what's up? Come on. Sing it with me now. We're going to the last section here. Let's bring it all together. Don't believe me, just watch. Gene Peng, funk you up. Xishan, funk you up. With me now. Gene Peng, funk you up. Xishan, funk you up. One more time. Gene Peng, funk you up. Xishan, funk you. Four more times. Gene Peng, funk you up. I said Xishan, funk you up. Come on. Gene Peng, funk you up. Xishan, funk you up. Even the guy in the back's clapping. Come on. Yeah. Xishan, funk you up. One more time. Gene Peng, funk you up. I said Xishan, funk you up. Come on now. Gene Peng, funk you up. Rah! Yeah, baby. Oh, y'all. Y'all nailed that one. Oh, this is a good crowd. So we got round two of this tonight at the Marriott School, and y'all putting a lot of pressure on those business students. Who said economists and international affairs students weren't cool? Nice work, ladies and gentlemen. Okay. Whoo! So, despite all of his enemies, and trust me, he's got a lot. Your average Joe loves Jinping almost as much as hot pot. You see, he's cleaning up the party. He makes life seem a little fairer. And most aren't that opposed to his political and social terror. His clampdown on Weibo, the Chinese version of Twitter, was kind of annoying, but frankly, not that many people are bitter. In the meantime, China's rising on the geopolitical stage. One minute, neighbors are enraged. The next, she's trying to assuage. The military is growing. She's China's biggest cheerleader. And that's why the people love him. Let's hear that track, Real Leader. Y'all know this one. This is your generation. Donna doesn't know this one. It's not her generation, but everybody else knows this one, I think. All right, here we go.
When we need motivation, we think about our China dream. It doesn't take long, yeah, yeah. Cause Xi Dada is in our corner, standing up to the fauners. All our past leaders were eat by now that she's on. We are strong, but they say, why do you like Xi? Is it cause his wife is pretty? Ain't this all show, crackdown, scary? We're like, no, not really. Cause, oh, I think that we found ourselves a real leader. She is always right there when he's needed. Oh, I think that we found ourselves a real leader. She is always right there when he's needed. She busts corrupt officials at a rate that's well beyond just superficial. Yeah, yeah, cause he's the wizard of real. Politique is his style. He can out-Kissinger, Kissinger, and Putin is his pal. So we say, yes, we like Xi, and yes, his wife is pretty. Do we care that he killed Weibo? We're like, no, not really, cause, oh, I think that we found ourselves a real leader. She is always right there when he's needed. Oh, I think that we found ourselves a real leader. She is always right there when he's needed.
So let me make you all a list of what Jinping's done. In just 3 short years, he got corruption on the run. The price of Baijiu tank, no more traffic controls. And despite slowing growth, he made his equity bowls. He got his hand in every pot with his party committees. American rappers popping Jinping ditties. I don't know how he does it all. Cause anybody weaker would have taken a fall. He got enemies at home and enemies abroad. But he built us up some items using Chinese sod. One belt, one road, AIIB. Is Xi's new and improved foreign policy. A paparazzi popolata, Xi cult of personality. Now it's the Xi Xi-P. Oh yeah.
She gives us strength and direction, da-da-dee dimension. You're the only one for us, no we don't need the next one. In 2022 we all will make the right selection. All that's left to do is pop a Putin style election. Oh, I think that we pound ourselves a real leader. She is always right there when he's needed.
Come on.
Oh, I think that we found ourselves a real leader. She's always right there when he's needed.
Yeah, man, right here, Big Daddy Door calling democratic elections in China, baby! 2022! Cheer! Cheer! Well, I think y'all get the point about politics in China, huh? So we move to economics. She's consolidated power, but that's not enough. They need to move away from investment and consume stuff. Their investment-led growth just ain't sustainable because total factor productivity growth is unattainable. They gotta rebalance, but that requires reform, implying short-term pain, slower growth, the new norm. When things get tough, then they tend to rely back on their investment because they love their FAI.
Domestic consumption must increase.
Yeah.
We must rebalance if we want to keep the peace.
I know.
Net exports falling, they've been way too high.
Sky high.
Well, that's all right because we love our FAI.
Yeah.
We love our FAI.
I can't tell you how it's gonna work. I can only tell you it'll happen. The next 5 years, we will restructure. Quit your finger snapping. The next 5 years, we got a plan. We won't be caught napping. The next 5 years, we will take action. Lower the wealth gap. And minimum wages on the rise. I know we must apologize. Redistribution of the income. It ain't no guys. We gotta enforce the labor law. Cause no one complies. She ain't on the rise. Lee, discontent is high. Indigenous innovation. It's so great in urbanization. It keeps on rolling at a high rate. Liberalization of the hukou is our mandate. And if you still can't access health insurance, please just wait. Understand we got a lot of stuff on our plate. We must make an efficient use of energy abate. Ain't no debate. I want party state. We'll create a harmonious society. Tay, tay.
Domestic
cheer.
Consumption must increase.
That's right.
Let's rebalance if we want to keep the peace.
That's right. That's right.
Net exports falling, they've been
way too high.
Well, that's all right.
All right, verse 2 here. This is what the ordinary people think about all this. Reaction to the government.
We love our FAI.
Since before 2003, we've been hearing about harmonious society, that the CCP has been pumping up our GDP, that their policies benefited all us equally, that the CCP's been working hard for you and me. Apologies that I'm an SKEPTIC, but this bureaucracy is causing mass uncertainty. Look at the money-wide flow to the SOEs. Why banks, telecoms, and energy monopolies? Why did LGFVs get 4 trillion RMB while household deposits are down as a share of GDP? I can't figure out why land and capital are almost free, but on the other hand, why I can't afford a property. Trust me, that rebate on my toes ain't enough for me. Trust me, FAI will keep growing, wait and see, cause that's how big capital makes all this cheese in this melodious society.
Domestic
come on.
Must increase.
Cheer.
Let's rebalance if we wanna keep the peace.
That's right, that's right.
Net exports falling, they've been
way too high.
Well, that's alright because we love our FAI.
F-A-I. Alright, verse 3, this is the party's response.
We love our FAI.
Self-defense. Now, I know we said things we promising that we haven't done, but y'all gotta admit, we've been slightly under the gun. 08, it was a great year till it filled us with fear. Olympic champions 1 month, the next are Lehman's in tears. And with those tears came chaos, the whole system went down. Smiles faded to frowns, to stimulus came to town. Year to 4 trillion quad gave us all a nice high. When we don't know what to do, we just boost FAI. You see, we got a limited demographic window. By 2015, we'll have a rising dependency ratio. So before the growth of our savings pool starts to slow, we gotta build up all our airports, bridges, and railroads. In between now and then, we got a political transition. 2012, power's ambition finally comes to fruition. So policy and admission is the likely rendition, cause all the policy cooks will take a break from the kitchen. Switching back on when they're ready to tackle the mission. Cheer! Come on!
Let's
if we want to keep the peace.
Come on, come on.
Net exports falling, they've been way too high. But that's all right, because we love our FAI. We love our FAI. We love our FAI.
Yeah, baby. Thank you very much. So we're gonna end with one more and then take questions. So we're gonna skip the one about pollution, if that's okay. But we're gonna finish with a macroeconomic one focused on finance and credit in the banking system. So what happens when growth drops too much? We start to stimulate. And if our early efforts do not work, then we just accelerate. Credit growth is key to boost GDP. But you know that things are dire when the more of the credit you inject, the worse the multiplier. Inefficient credit, yep, you said it, can kill a banking system. And though the warning signs were flashing red, we were either late or just plain missed them. Either way, it's our only play when growth is teetering on the edge. We call it magic, baby. Credit growth is our counter-cyclical hedge.
Hi, my name's Shang Fu Lin.
And I approve this message.
I've got the magic in me. Every time I issue debt, it turns to GDP. Every time I knows I've got the magic in me. With MPL so low, I worry PBOC. 'Cause everybody wants a burst of magic, 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 magic.
Ooh.
It's true, our credit growth will blow your mind. Picking it, any year, my favorite is 2009. Bank loans were up that year, stratosphere in the sky. At 33% year on year, that ain't no lie. And then we tightened up a bit, them LGFVs were hit. Property and steel, say what's the deal, we cannot handle it. It didn't take them long to find the trust, they started banking it. CBRC's like, what's up man, what's happening? And then the interbank market stole the show last year. Zhou Xiaochuan tightened up till he felt the pressure from the premier. We don't like moral hazard, but it's stability we fear. So call me LeBron James, the king, 'cause I'm so cavalier.
I've got the
magic in me. Every time I issue debt, it turns to GDP. Everybody knows I've got the magic in me.
Issuing credit, baby.
With NPL so low, I worry PBOC. 'Cause everybody wants a burst of magic, 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 magic.
Come on,
magic, magic, magic.
Said we gonna liberalize. Interest rates been minimized. Net interest margins might collapse if we competitivize. Wealth management products in the meantime have materialized. See shadow banking products we sell 10 at a time. BBOC doing QE through CDB. A trillion renminbi of lending supplementary. We cannot bear to miss our target for the GDP, 'cause politically it's sensitive within the CCP. We save all defaults for fear of something systematic. We take all the bad loans and put them in the AMC attic. Deleveraging's our nightmare. Nightmare and would surely wreak havoc. Debt to GDP 250, this should not be problematic.
Evergreen, every time I issue debt, it turns to GDP. Everybody knows bad loans are all evergreen. NPL so low, I worry PBOC. 'Cause everybody wants a burst of magic, magic. Magic, 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 magic.
Magic. Yeah,
we love our LGFA.
Hey,
that, I got that.
Hey,
I got the magic in me. Hey, that, I got that. Hey, I got the magic in me. Hey, that. Hey, I got the magic in me. Hey, that. We love our LGFAs.
Thank you very much. Q&A?
I don't know what we'll get, but it'll be fun.
Sure, please.
So, Andrew, you've proven to the students here that studying China and economics can be fun and interesting and very entertaining. So maybe my classes will fill up more now. The Beijing State of Mind that we played before the program officially started is on YouTube, so that's seen around the world, but some of this other stuff is not. I'm just wondering what kind of response you get in China to some of this stuff, and are you worried about your visa?
So that's a common question I get. So the other videos that I showed are on YouTube. They're on sort of my YouTube channel, which is public, but I have like two or three layers of disassociation from my actual name, which probably would do nothing, frankly, if the Chinese really wanted to figure out who's posting these videos, especially when people comment, "Hey, nice job, Andrew," and then it sort of loses the anonymity. But I guess the reason I publish, I publish them and then kind of send them to friends, but you can only see them with a VPN in China because YouTube is blocked, and they're all, for the most part, in English. And so I guess my view is, the Chinese government has a lot to deal with. These are getting, Beijing State of Mind got, 200,000 on YouTube and maybe a million total if you include the Chinese versions of YouTube, but that's still pretty small. These are getting 2,000 hits. I mean, this is not, and again, foreign language and can't be accessed onshore without a VPN. So I thought about that. And the Run This Town, the first one, the politically a little bit more sensitive, where I talk about assets of the top leadership family, that one I waited to post for like 3 years, but then I finally said, then they don't really care about this stuff. So if I lose my visa, I'll come be a teaching assistant or something.
Xiexie ni, Andrew, Lai Bai Fang Woman. You're welcome anytime.
Thank you.
My name is Danny. I write raps during sacrament meeting, usually about Jesus, but I have a long ways to go, so thank you for inspiration. My question stems from China's economic trajectory, given the fact that for the first time in 30 years, it's finally slowing down. The housing market's bursting, the shadow banking practices are catching up to it, and the stock market instability is ruining a lot of people's lives. So from your economic standpoint, where do you see China going here in the near future?
Great question. I think that, in fact, that's basically the question I get paid to research on an ongoing basis. I guess the first thing I would say about you writing raps in sacrament meeting, lest anyone think that's sacrilegious, I would just rephrase it, you're writing poetry in sacrament meeting, which you might later put a beat to. Interestingly, my first rap that I ever wrote was in the MTC. So I had done my parody stuff on the guitar before that, but then you can't have a guitar in the MTC, and my roommate happened to be a good beatboxer, so I wrote a rap about the MTC.
I'm with you on sacrament meeting rap writing. On China, I mean, I think so the first thing I would say is I think market sentiment and international media sentiment tends to swing pretty dramatically vis-a-vis China. So things are slowing. They have a lot of challenges ahead of them. All of those challenges we've known about for the last, let's just say 5 years plus. And the fundamentals, although they're slowing, haven't fallen off a cliff. So the international market reactions, I think, maybe are either catching up to the realities in China or have maybe exceeded some of the realities. Probably the biggest concern is, although the stock market is one, and I'll get to that in a second, the biggest concern is the currency, because that has huge macroeconomic implications, not just for China, but for other countries, whereas the domestic equity market is important for China to some extent, but not that important for the rest of the world, other than as a sentiment, signal. So I think that's really what global markets are concerned about, which is why you saw a lot of move in other emerging market currencies when the renminbi dropped a couple percentages in August and then again in December, January. And I think that angst, both not just offshore but onshore as well, grows exponentially with each incident where they do a minor devaluation without great communication. And the PBOC, not being an independent central bank, doesn't have the authority to come out and communicate their strategies and what their plans are. as freely as other independent central banks are. And so there's a lot of bureaucratic tension around what should be announced and when and by whom. And so that leads to, I think, poor communication to the markets, which makes all of this a lot worse. And so you know, the markets come out and say, ah, you know, they're devaluing. This is gonna, they're gonna do a big one-off 30% devaluation, you know, against the dollar very soon. And I think that's an example, in my opinion. I could be wrong. Maybe next week that happens. But I think that's an opinion. That's an example of where the market tends to overshoot the realities and not take into consideration the political realities that exist in the policymaking process. That doesn't get to all of the parts of your question, but it's a start. Yeah, we'll probably get into some of the other stuff.
Hi, my name is Haley Peterson. I'm studying political science. A few years back, I had the opportunity to represent China at a Model United Nations conference and did a lot of research into the one-child policy. And I know you mentioned that in one of the songs. So I was just wondering, recently, you know, that was something that was kind of a loosened social policy. Yeah. Do you see that as a stepping stone to listing other social policies? Or do you see that there's a specific reason for, you know, less regulation on that specific policy?
Great question. Then before I answer it, I would just say I know some of you have to go to classes, so don't be shy about just getting up and leaving as you need to. I'm happy to take questions until the end of the hour. So on the one-child policy, I think it's probably a bit of both, but I think it's more specific to the one-child policy. So the one-child policy is horrible for China's demographics, and that's just starting to play into the economy. And that's going to be a huge drag on economic growth because supply of labor is one of the key factors of economic growth. So as the labor force starts to shrink in China, you will have to, in order to offset that and maintain or increase growth levels, you have to offset that with increased productivity of labor and productivity of capital. So it's going to be a huge challenge for them. So they knew that from a policy standpoint that at some point they would need to loosen it. And by the way, they had already loosened it. So certain people of non-Han minorities, all the other minorities could have already two, and in some cases in the countryside you could have three if your first two weren't a boy. And then about 10 or 15 years ago, they allowed two single children, if they got married, to have two children. So that's already been in place for quite a while. Mm-hmm. And then they just loosened it to allow it so that if one of them was, and now that everybody can have two. So it's been a progression, frankly, of liberalization, but a lot of the best demographers in Beijing have been saying for a while, actually, you know, if you look at other East Asian countries similar to China, their birth rates are already very low. And so we should loosen this now because, you know, there's not going to be a sudden baby boom. But there are getting back to the issue of political considerations in the policymaking process, there's a huge ministry in charge of family planning, like, you know, tens if not hundreds of thousands of bureaucrats in charge of controlling the birth policy in China. What do you do with them when you get rid of a policy, right? So there's a whole vested interest. This sounds strange, but there's a vested interest in the Ministry of Family Planning and Urban Health that doesn't want to see this thing go away because their power is at risk, yeah, and their jobs are at risk.
Thank you.
Sure.
Hi, my name's John.
Hi, John.
I'm an international relations student here at BYU. As far as studying it, I've looked into some of the economics, but I have a question for you more on the foreign policy and
sure.
economic side. With recent problems with, I guess, the humanitarian crisis that's growing in North Korea, many people, I guess many other researchers, are worried about the economic ramifications that's going to have on China should refugees start to flee across the border. Is there anything that you see China can do to help prevent or helps, I guess, with that potential crisis?
That's a great question. I'm not a North Korea expert, but I sort of hear about these issues from folks I talk to. You know, the Chinese-North Korean relationship has deteriorated pretty substantially in the last 5 to 10 years, especially, I think, since the new leader in North Korea has taken his position. And so the control they used to have over North Korea, at least most pundits sort of now think, has to a great degree has gone away. They're still the closest allies in North Korea, but they clearly can't control them anymore. From the standpoint of refugees and economic crisis, I mean, that's the last thing China wants. So in my opinion, they would do just about everything. Well, it's the last thing China wants for two reasons. One, if you get too much instability, it also leads to political instability, and they don't want a unified Korea under Southern Korean leadership as a U.S. ally. So they don't want a border basically with a U.S. ally. So strategically, they want to make sure that as goofy as the North Korean regime seems and sometimes acts, that they remain in place. Sort of status quo, frankly, I think actually for most parties is the best outcome right now. So although the U.S. and China and Russia and other members of the six-party talks sort of try and come back to the table, and sometimes they pull out sanctions or impose sanctions or pull away subsidies, and they kind of go back and forth depending on North Korean behavior. At the end of the day, my guess would be, and again, I'm not an expert, that they support the regime, enough to prevent a humanitarian crisis. But there's more risk of that not happening now that the relationship with China has deteriorated the way it has. Thanks for joining, everybody, and thanks for participating. You guys were amazing. Best crowd I've ever played for.